Hello, my name is Megan Crass, and I'm a physician assistant in the primary care department at UW-Madison's University Health Services. Today I'm here to talk about the question, how do I make the decision to get the COVID-19 vaccine? So as a healthcare provider, the decision to vaccinate myself and my family was a pretty easy one, but I know this is not at all an easy decision for a lot of people who have questions about the safety or necessity of these vaccines. I'm here today to talk about some of these concerns. As we know, a COVID-19 virus can cause a disease with very serious and sometimes long-term side effects. Vaccination is the single most effective thing you can do to protect yourself and your loved ones from getting and spreading COVID-19. If you're vaccinated, you should feel safe resuming the activities you enjoyed before the pandemic. Some people worry that these vaccines are new and may not have been tested properly. However, the COVID-19 vaccines available in the U.S. are actually the result of over 10 years of medical research that was applied to the situation of the pandemic during the time of need. The vaccines that are available to now are the ones that really passed the test as far as their safety and efficacy. Vaccines, like everything else we put in our body, do have side effects. Luckily, the vast majority of these side effects are mild to moderate. Things like body aches, fevers, headaches, injection site pain or swelling, things that are annoyances but aren't overly serious and only last a day or two. There, of course, are some more serious side effects that can occur, but luckily, these things are extremely rare and we know a lot about the potential of these things occurring and how to treat them if they do happen. We do encourage people to talk to their employers or their school about options for leave if you're among the people who do have side effects that may require you to miss school or work as a result of getting the vaccination. We also remind people that the vaccines are available at no cost, both through University Health Services and a lot of other community sites. We also recommend that people who have questions still about the vaccine and how it applies to their own personal health situation, talk to their healthcare provider or other vaccinated people that they trust to see what special considerations they might have. Just want to stress one more time that vaccination is really the best way to protect yourself, your loved ones, and your community from COVID-19.